What is going on, guys? It's your boy Killer Cam. So this was the this was not the original show I had in mind today. I actually had WrestleMania 3 that I wanted to review. But then I looked on the calendar and I saw that it was February 11th. And I said, why not review a show that happened 5 years ago today? So we're going to get into this. This is NXT Takeover Rival, which took place February 11th, 2015 from Full Sail University in Winter Park, Florida. The opening match of the night was Tyler Breeze and Hideo Itami. And if you just saw the rating I had down on the screen, you'll see what I thought about this match. I thought it was a really great match to keep the crowd hot. You saw I rated this match 3.5 stars out of 5. I think these two guys really went out and put on a hell of a show to start out. I loved this match. I loved the uniqueness of this match. I was surprised going back seeing that Hideo Itami was as over as he was, because he seemed to be really over. And, you know, I remember seeing the show 5 years ago thinking Itami had, you know, big things going for him. And now Itami's not even in the WWE anymore that I know of. I don't think he is in the WWE. But Breeze did come out aggressively early on. Itami found an early opening. Breeze looked aggressive in this match, but Itami ended up winning with a running drop kick followed by a boot to the face off the ropes. Like I said, awesome match. Perfect way to open up the show and get the crowd hot. It was incredible. I like the opening match, but only best to come. So next up we saw, it was interesting to see Corbin's work now, seeing like how far he's come since this point 5 years ago. I give this match less than 2 stars though. It was decent for what it was. You know, I mean, it was no DQ and it was 4 minutes. So you really kind of can't expect anything of the ordinary. Bull cost Corbin a chance at the tournament final. That was Corbin's loss. They brawled right away. I like the vibe and energy. Corbin finish looked off as well. They botched the Cactus Clothesline for a no DQ match. They didn't do anything wild and it didn't play a major part in the match. So in a way it felt like a waste, since NXT had not done much in the way of gimmick matches up to that point. Corbin won as he should have. The match wasn't all that good. The crowd was into it though, but the sloppiness hurt what could have been a fun brawl. Like I said, there was really nothing to this match. I didn't really like it. Like I said, you know, it wouldn't be that bad, but to me, you know, it was one of the weaker points of the show. So then next up you get into a tag match between the Lucha Dragons and Blake and Murphy. And I think the only one that's in the WWE right now is Murphy. Kalisto might still be there, but I'm pretty sure it's just Murphy. So Wesley Blake and Buddy Murphy were coming in here having won the titles a few weeks before this. Sin Cara blew a head scissors early. Then Kalisto nearly blew out a knee when he messed up a step-up dive to the floor. This was the worst start to a match possible. You saw that I gave it 1.5 stars out of 5. He tried really hard and did a series of near falls that seemingly went on for minutes. No one gave a single solidarity. Nobody gave a shit about in this match, honestly. That's not a good thing. The champions retained again. They tried, but even with some good work at times, this was overall not a good match. This was really bad night for the Lucha Dragons. Wesley and Murphy were fun. It was what it was. Then they got a, you know, I mean, hey, you know, you get some good and some bad. And this was one of the weaker parts of Takeover Rival for me. I mean, these four guys went out and tried to have a good match, but the match just didn't really do much for me. You know, This one never got off the ground, like I said. It suffered from some early botches. Both teams just seemed really out of sync for the rest of the match. All the counters made it much harder for them to get on the same page. They never really did. I mean, so, yeah, it really was what it was. But, I mean, after this match, this show would pick up in a huge, huge way. By the way, we got a Solomon Crow video package on the show as well. I guess he debuted at NXT. We would get a huge number one contenders match between Adrian Neville and Finn Balor. I gave this match 4.25 stars out of 5. This match was absolutely incredible. Neville went to the outside at first, hopped up on the apron to stop a dive from Balor. He caught Balor off guard. There was some interesting stuff in this match. I like Neville. He hit a sweet corkscrew moonsault off the middle rope, which is very impressive. Balor responded with a bloody Sunday. I think he hit a 1916 as well and a sling blade in this match. Balor ended up winning with a coup de grace. It was awesome. This was really great to go on. Third to last. Really set the bar high for the last two matches. Like I said, solid stuff. This was a number one contenders match. So the winner of this match would face the winner of the NXT championship match later in the night. I mean, it was just, like I said, with these two guys, though, you know, they had great chemistry. You know, two phenomenal workers in the ring. You know, I really can't complain about nothing with this match. You know, I really can't. You know, I was looking for something to try to critique because I like to be a critic. But when something's good, something's good. You know, I'm a critic by, you know, choice. But, you know, when something's good, you got to give it its due. This match was good. It would not be the best match of the night. It would be close, but it would not be the best match. I loved how these guys, though, you know, these guys just had a great work rate going into this match. And just, you know, you could tell that both of these guys' hearts were into the match. And I think that that was something that I really, really appreciated about this match, was these guys wanted to go out, put on a hell of a match, put on a hell of a fight. And that's exactly what they ended up doing. They ended up putting on one hell of a fight. And I think it was a phenomenal matchup. Great match. And you'd have more to come. So yeah, great win there by Finn Balor. We would transition into the Fatal 4-Way Women's Match for the NXT Women's Championship. This match, I give 4 out of 5 stars. Phenomenal women's match. I mean, when you had the four horsewomen, Bayley, Becky, Sasha, Charlotte, and to see this match today, from 2020 eyes, you know, watching this match back in 2015, you wouldn't think that all of these women would have been as big as what they were. You know, they were primed for the main roster. All of these women, you know, Becky being the man now, Charlotte being the queen, you know, Bayley doing her thing as SmackDown Women's Champ, and Sasha coming back here soon, Becky being Raw Women's Champ. It's amazing to see how far these women have come. And this was, you know, Charlotte was champion going in. Sasha ended up winning by pinning Charlotte. All three challengers ended up getting taken out. Ended up taking out Charlotte at the beginning of the match. Lynch threw her into the video board on the hard cam side, which I thought was pretty cool. Lynch stepped aside for Banks, caught her from behind with a pump handle suplex. That was a nice bump there I liked. Lynch went to work on Bayley, but it wasn't long before Banks stepped in and she was followed by Charlotte. The match was complete chaos, though, which was pretty cool. Bayley hit a belly to belly on Charlotte, but Lynch pulled her off the cover. Bayley and Lynch brought her to the outside until Banks came out of nowhere with a dive onto both of them. All three of them recovered. Charlotte got up first, threw Lynch into the ring, but Lynch countered and set her up on the top. Banks locked in a crossface, but then Charlotte used the ropes for leverage, and Banks ended up using a crucifix pin. Show-stealing performance. Simple as that. You know, I really do believe that outside of Charlotte and Natalya, this was the real first women's match that really made me, you know, put these women on the map and really made me think, hey, you know, it's crazy though seeing how many good matches these women have had, you know, since this night. You know, how far these women have really come and have pushed the main, you know, the envelope and the main roster. And later on this year, we're going to be talking about a lot of the takeover matches between Bayley and Sasha. You know, I mean, it was incredible to me to see, like I said, the progress that all of these women made. And this match was just a preview. You know, this match was incredible. I mean, when you have these four women doing their absolute best, it was going to steal the show. Regardless of whatever match was going to happen, you knew it was going to steal the show. You know, it was incredible. I loved it. You know, loved it. Next match, though, you had Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens. It was a battle of best friends. Owens had beaten CJ Parker at TakeOver R Evolution, and Zayn had won the NXT title. The thing I love about this match, you know, a lot of people may gripe that it's a no finish. I loved it because it showed that Sami Zayn had heart. He was never pinned. The match ended due to ref stoppage, and Kevin Owens would become the new NXT champion. There was a couple good spots in this match. Owens was on the offensive for a very long time, dominating Zayn. Zayn started to get things going, just as Corey Graves was comparing his beatdown to the one Lesnar gave John Cena at SummerSlam. Zayn had the offense working and looked to be going for the Huluva kick, but Owens hit the charging Zayn with a super kick and followed with a cannonball in the corner. Zayn continued to fight back as he got Owens to the outside. He went for a split-legged moonsault off the top to the outside, but appeared to hit his head on the ramp. Zayn was out of it for the rest of the match. He tried to go for a Huluva kick, but he stumbled, which he did a great job selling it here. Great, great job. Both of these guys had a tremendous work rate. Owens kept attacking Zayn with punches, and the ref pulled him off. Owens came close to being DQ'd multiple times. Zayn wanted to fight on, though, but Owens kept hitting him with power bombs until finally the ref called for the bell. Owens looked very upset, and the crowd joined him in that feeling until the referee unexpectedly walked up to Owens and held his hand in the air. The ref then grabbed a belt and presented it to Owens. The show ended with Owens holding the title. The only thing that fell flat about this match was Zayn's beatdown that he suffered, mostly because the announcers didn't really sell into anything until Zayn hit his head on the ramp. That was too late into the match. You know, and that's another thing, is announcers can really take out into the match. You know, I gave the match 4.5 out of 5. Could have easily been 5. You know, it could have easily been 4. You know, I've seen some people rate it 4, 4.25. I've seen some people rate that women's match. You know, see, my ratings are a little bit different. I'm not going to go with what Meltzer says. I'm going to go with what I think. And I loved this match. I thought it was incredible. I thought these two men really went out, and Sammy basically was exhausted and told a good story. And, you know, it basically showed, hey, Owens won the title without actually winning the match, in a way. You know, I mean, and just, you know, it's showing Sami Zayn's heart, the fact that he had a will to continue and a will to compete, really, really gives me, you know, great, great feelings about this show. But you know, there were some pros and cons to this show, and I've kind of already discussed it in the review, so I'm really just going to tell you guys real quick the pros that I liked. The women's fatal four-way, Owens versus Zayn, Neville versus Balor, Breeze versus Atami, and I like Zayn's heart that he had in this. The cons that I did not like in this, I did not like on this show, was Lucha Dragons against Blake and Murphy, Corbin versus Dempsey. If I had to give a final grade for this show, I would give it an A+. It was an awesome show. I'm going to rate it a 9 out of 10. That's how tremendous this show was. You know, check it out when you get a chance.